Hello, my name is Evan Duffield, and I am the founder and lead developer of Dash. And this is a video series about Dash. And so in this video, this is just an introduction to Dash at a really high level of all of the basic concepts of the technology. So to start, what exactly is Bitcoin? Well, Bitcoin is a revolutionary technology, and it is basically a currency that operates without a central bank. And what that means is anyone on the network can actually send money from anywhere to anywhere with no one in between. It's also more anonymous than other digital alternatives, and it's actually the very first of its kind. So if Bitcoin is so amazing, why are we working on Dash? The issue is Bitcoin isn't perfect, and the Bitcoin project is going in a different direction than where we want it to go. And in a free market, we should explore as many ideas as possible so that the best ideas rise to the top and benefit everyone. And so some of the issues with Bitcoin are that it is slower than centralized systems, and it lacks some things that centralized corporations do really well, like having a governance and management methodology plus a funding source that's recurring and stable. And on top of that, it has a lot of economic issues. And we strive to solve all of these issues within Dash. What exactly is Dash? Well, Dash stands for digital cash. And what that means is it's an alternative to cash that's just purely on the internet. And it's decentralized in nature and just purely digital. It's also fungible, which means that any two single units of Dash are interchangeable and that no one can know the difference between them because they have no history. There's also privacy on the network, and privacy is a highly valued thing within the Dash ecosystem. We have very quick transaction speed using some innovative features, and we incentivize network participation. We also have methodologies for governing the currency that are very well defined, so that we don't run into roadblocks where the community can't tell where we're going. And this also allows the community to participate in the decision-making process of our currency. And beyond that, we have permanent recurring funding. And then beyond all of these features that the currency has, we have set up the very first virtual corporation. One of the biggest differentiators between Dash and other projects is that we are constantly innovating within the Dash ecosystem. And we do this by innovating at the core protocol level. What we want to do is to create all of the services that a currency needs in completely decentralized ways so that they are available to all of the users on the network forever. And this is a really important time within Dash to get all of this technology right before we actually have a stable, maintainable infrastructure for the future. In the Bitcoin ecosystem, they actually had to lock down experimentation early on because it drew so much investment that they actually wanted to protect that investment and keep the network completely stable. And we feel like they left a lot of room for improvement. And so that's where we come in, and we're trying to implement the things like privacy, instant transactions, incentives all the way around using only decentralized technologies that are available forever to the entire network. Earlier, we had said that in the Bitcoin ecosystem, transaction speeds had a lot of room for improvement. And it's true, in Bitcoin, transactions can take up to about 60 minutes to have confidence that they actually won't be double spent against. And what it means is you can send a transaction on a decentralized network. So you promise to give somebody money, and then you actually take away that promise and someone else gets the money, or you spend the money back to yourself in some way. Well, in Dash, we actually circumvent this problem entirely. And so we can get confirmation of a transaction within 1 second. And it's amazing because they're also completely double spend proof. We use decentralized oracles to do this, or our sub-quorum system. So So on Dash, you can make a promise about sending money to a given party. And then utilizing the network, you actually have to keep that promise. This is actually really important for point of sale type situations, where you go into a merchant and you buy something and then you want to walk out of the store immediately. And we have the technology that would actually make this possible, much like credit cards. Fungibility is another area that Dash has improved greatly upon the cryptographic technology. And in Dash, from time to time, the history is actually removed from all of the coins on the network. And this allows every coin to be equal to every other coin. If you walk into a merchant and then you buy something and you give them a $100 bill, that $100 bill is worth exactly $100. Now, if you walk in and you give him a Bitcoin, that Bitcoin might have come from a recent illegal activity, and then its value might actually fall over time because no one wants to be associated with illegal activities on the network. And this is just something that no one really should have to worry about using a currency. And so we believe that fungibility is something that the currency should take care of itself without users really having to get involved. And so we've invented a system which any user can utilize it, and it's very cost efficient to remove the history from coins utilizing this method. It uses something called DarkSend, and DarkSend utilizes our second tier infrastructure, which we'll get into later. DarkSend is 100% secure, and we've had it audited by security professionals and improved by the community itself. And no one has ever traced coins through DarkSend. It's also completely decentralized and trustless. Well, how about network participation? This is actually where we first start to see foundational cracks in the Bitcoin ecosystem. The infrastructure is actually donated at the expense of the users and companies utilizing the systems. And as costs rise, it actually squeezes out those people that are most vulnerable to the cost of running these services, and then weakens the network as a whole. Well, how did Dash fix this? Dash has a special class of servers we call our second tier infrastructure. Our second tier infrastructure is also known as the Masternode network. And this is a compensated infrastructure because they provide services to the network such as syncing clients and propagating messages. Plus, they're paid to do this. Any user can run a Masternode on our network, and we try to lure in the most talented people to run these for us. And so we have systems administrators and programmers and other talented people that are running this part of our infrastructure for the network itself. Governance is also another topic that is rarely discussed within peer-to-peer networks. And this is because no peer-to-peer network has ever grown to the size where it has to deal with issues like, which direction are we going in? And should we take the opinions of the community seriously, or how are decisions made if the community split here or there with this decision or that decision? And for something to be successful, again, like a centralized corporation, you need a clear governance methodology. And we've implemented this in a brand new way that has never been seen before in any type of software. It decentralizes our decision-making process among thousands of people. In Bitcoin, there has never been a clear way to decide anything for the project, and this has led to all sorts of problems within their ecosystem. What about funding? Funding is something that is often overlooked for decentralized projects, and most decentralized projects actually operate at the expense of the people who created them. And this can only happen for so long before people get tired of paying for things. And so we've created a decentralized revenue source for Dash so that it can pay for things like salaries of its employees, it can pay for website design, website building, hiring contractors to do all sorts of things for us. running marketing campaigns for public awareness, and even paying for legal expenses. It's a very robust funding source for us, and it will allow us to try to grow the funding source into something more substantial for the future. And having something that is self-sustaining and completely decentralized is very important to the Dash project's success long-term. So that was it for the introduction to Dash. In the next video, we will be going over our virtual corporation and how that functions. See you there.